Hey, my name's George and this is a soldering iron. The ergonomic comfort grip, along with the interchangeable chisel and conical tip, makes it easy to execute soldering projects. If you don't have the kit, you'll need to gather some necessary items to begin soldering. This includes soldering iron, stand, solder wire, sponges, screwdriver, and safety gear. If you need to change the tip of the soldering iron, using a small screwdriver, locate the set screw on the side of the iron and begin to loosen. The set screw holds the tip in place, so loosening it will allow you to remove the old tip and replace it with the new one. Use a screwdriver to tighten the set screw back into place to ensure the tip is secure. Before we turn the soldering iron on, using a damp sponge, clean the tip to remove any oxidation or debris. This will improve its performance. Next, plug the soldering iron in to turn it on. From here, turn the soldering iron on. Allow it to warm up for a few minutes and the indicator light will turn off when it's ready to be used. Next up, you need to test the soldering iron. Apply a small amount of solder to the tip. Now that everything's all set and looking good, you can begin soldering. Hold the soldering iron against the material to heat it up. The heat from the soldering iron will cause the solder to melt, creating a strong connection between your materials. Once you've finished soldering your project, remove your soldering iron and allow the solder to cool. And remember, don't forget to turn off your soldering iron. Whilst your soldering iron is still warm, you need to clean it using either a damp sponge or a brass tip cleaner. This will remove any remaining solder from the tip and help prevent oxidation. And there you have it, the steps to set up and use your soldering iron. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe for more tips and tricks.